Welcome to the lesson on nets for 3D figures. In this lesson, we will discuss how to identify and describe three-dimensional figures and their two-dimensional nets. So it's important to recognize that all three-dimensional figures can be broken down into a two-dimensional net. Nets have certain characteristics that allow us to gather important information about that figure, make conclusions, and then of course solve problems. So let's think about the nets of most prisms. When I look at the net of a prism, I gotta think, what shape do I see twice? In this case, I see two pentagons. So those two pentagons are the bases of my prism. So I'm gonna have a pentagonal prism because I can count five sides. The five lateral surfaces, in this case, these five squares, make up the lateral area of this pentagonal prism. So when laid flat, I see two bases and then the five lateral squares or rectangles. Now a pyramid is a little bit different. A pyramid only has one base. In this case, what looks like a star will actually be a pentagonal pyramid. That is because the point of each of these triangles, when folded up, will meet up at the top, directly above the base, at the pyramid's apex. Now, with these nets, I can also talk about edges and vertices, and I can think about how many corners do I have? How many points do I have where multiple faces meet? In this case, in this pentagonal prism, I can count the amount of edges, I can count the vertices, and I can count the faces to then make conclusions about exactly what I have. Now, as I think about nets of prisms and pyramids, we'll take a look. If I fold up that net of that pyramid, although this example does have rectangles, I can see I achieved exactly what was being described, a pentagonal prism and a pentagonal pyramid. Now look at the example of a cylinder. A cylinder does not have polygon bases, but I still have two identical circles on the top and one lateral area rectangle that wraps around at the edge to make a cylinder. A cone is a little bit different. We have one circular base and the lateral area, which is a sector of a circle that wraps around that base and meets at the top at the cone's apex. Let's take a look at a quick practice problem that we can use to hopefully describe a figure. So now I think what figure is being described. I have two identical bases. It is an octagon in this case, with eight sides. If I have then eight identical lateral areas, in this case squares, it's safe to conclude that I have an octagonal prism. Now let's take a look at this figure, this three-dimensional figure made up of identical pentagons, which we can call a dodecahedron. Let's think about how many faces this has, how many various faces I can count, making sure to be careful as I manipulate this figure in my mind to not overlap. I can count 12 bases. As I go to the edges, I definitely have to be careful not to count an edge twice. It'd be easy to think, well, 12 times 5 edges of each pentagon would give me 60. But because some of the edges repeat, I can simply know that I would have half the amount of unique edges, which would give me 30. And again, because so many of those vertices are shared by three pentagons, I can take that 60, divide it by 3, and get a final answer of 20.